transport stocks really lead the market? Well, if you look at the Dow Jones Transportation Index against the Dow, well, they track pretty closely, right? But we should hope that that's not the case, because lately the transportation stocks have been down as the Dow powers higher. But if you believe in Dow theory, Don Broughton, Managing Director and Senior Research Analyst at Avondale Partners, has something he thinks is better. He created a new index that shows pricing for truckload carriers, and he joins us now. Don, good to see you on the program.
Good to be here.
Tell us how your index is going to be better than the transportation index.
Well, what we've done is we have partnered with Cass Information Systems, which is the largest payer of freight bills in the United States. They pay over $17 billion worth of freight bills every year. So I'd say that's more than just a little statistically significant sample size. We've helped go through their data with them and ferret it out to be very pure, and not including fuel surcharge, not including accessorials, just what is the base rate being paid. We just came out with a report on the truckload segment. We're going to go out and do all the other segments as well. And we'll know exactly what's being paid, not only in real time, real data, but in real time. So we put out, for instance, the September data just now.
And what is that data telling you about this industry? Which, whatever you want to think about the transportation index, there's no doubt that these can be leading indicator companies.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, there's never been an economic resurgence in the last 45 years without there first being a resurgence in freight, particularly truck freight. There's never been a fall off in the economy in the last 45 years without there at least being a fall off first in truck freight. So we think this is very predictive. But what it says is that in September, the line haul rates for truckload went up by 11.7%.
Don, do you think that any of that is the result of consolidation, people filling
sure.
pipeline? In other words, stuff that is not sustainable.
Oh, well, there's really three dynamics going on. There's capacity, there's demand, and there's regulation. So capacity, we had a record number of companies go out of business in the trucking industry in this last downturn. We ordered and built far too few trucks over the last four or five years, first because companies didn't have the capital, and now because they're reluctant to spend the capital, given all the new regulations, and because it's more difficult to find a driver. The average age of the nation's fleet is at an all-time high, and let's face it, an 8-year-old truck is just less productive than a 1-year-old truck because it breaks down more often, it's in the maintenance shed more often, but that's all the capacity side of it. The demand side of it actually continues to be very strong. Retail may be flat to spotty, but major U.S. companies have reshored. We've seen companies beyond the GMs and Fords, companies like Otis Elevator, people like United Technologies, bring manufacturing back from not only Mexico but in Europe, but even China.
That is good. A little bit of good news on this Monday, Don. We appreciate it. Thanks for bringing a new index to Street Signs. We'll see you again soon.
My pleasure.
All right.